Today, we're going to be talking about data products, a trending topic in the data management space. So at a high level, we'll be covering what are data products, what are the key characteristics that make up a data product, and where do these data products live? And throughout this video, we'll be using a grocery store shopping analogy to help simplify the topics and help connect the dots. But before we do, I'd like to set the stage with our market perspective. So currently right now, organizations have vast amounts of data, and there's an extreme high demand for AI and data-driven insights than never before. Now, with that comes some complications or struggles. First is data silos. So having different data and assets and databases and it not being easy accessible or visible to the rest of the organization. Think of a cookie jar in a particular room of a house. Only people within that room have access to the cookie jar. Now, since we're talking about access, end consumers really struggle being able to have access to the right data at the right time when they need it. And once they finally get their hands on the right data, then there's an issue with being able to understand this data. So they spend a lot of time massaging and getting this data into a format that they can understand, that the lines of business can understand and be able to actually derive value from that. And that's data literacy. Now, once end consumers find the data they need, they get access to the data, they have it in the format they can understand, now there's a question of the quality of that data. Can I trust this data? Is this the most up-to-date version of the data? What type of transformations happened along the way as this was delivered to me? And in today's world of generative AI and traditional machine learning, you really need to be able to trust your data to be able to trust the outputs of your machine learning models. So now that we've covered the market landscape and some of the pain points that organizations are facing today, I'm going to define what a data product is by running through the key characteristics that make up a data product. First, multiple assets. Data products are not made up of one asset. It's made up of multiple different assets. Similar to how products within a grocery store, they're not made up of just one ingredient. They're made up of multiple different ingredients to create that product. Next, data products are meant to be reusable for multiple different use cases. Just like how you can buy a bag of apples, you can eat one apple, you can use three of those apples to make an apple pie, and you can use the remainder to make an applesauce. It's reusable for multiple different use cases. Next, data products need to have a defined domain. This helps it to where end users that are coming into the marketplace can be able to find the products that they're looking for. So a domain could be sales, human resources, operations, just like how a grocery store has different departments and different aisles. Data products are meant to be packaged in a user-friendly packaging. And this packaging explains to the end user, how to use it, terms and conditions, the value of the product. And similar to how when we look at packaging of a product in a grocery store, we can see the ingredients in it, we can understand its expiration date. It gives us information about what that product is. The same applies to data products. Next is access control. When you're working with data products, you're working with a lot of different data and assets. Some of this data could be, it could be client information, it could be social security numbers, it could be credit card numbers, addresses. This is all information that you're going to want to have protected, and you're going to want to be able to govern this. So we do that through different levels of access control, to where if an end user or an end consumer is trying to grab a particular data product that has PI information in it, they're going to have to request that information. Same as if I'm in the grocery store and I want to buy some wine, I'm going to have to probably walk up to a clerk, ask them to either unlock the cabinet for the wine, or I'm going to have to show my ID as I check out. It gives that access control. The same applies to data products. Next is quality and lifecycle management. As you go into a grocery store, the produce on the shelves are going to be not expired. They're going to be FDA approved. The store, the store employees are going to be making sure they're taking off the expiration, the expired products, and ensuring, what's there is actually fresh. Same applies to data products within the marketplace. You don't want to have a bunch of data products that are poor quality or are not usable anymore. So the data producers who are creating these data products ultimately are responsible for ensuring the quality of this data and for following certain service lines agreements saying, hey, I'll refresh this data product, every 30 days. This ensures that there's a good lifecycle management of the data product and that the data products that are inside the marketplace are of high quality and usable. Last but not least is delivery channels. So you would want to have multiple different delivery channels within your marketplace for a variety of different reasons. First and foremost is because there are different consumers that are going to need different delivery mechanisms. Some are going to need to download it. Some just need to view this data product. Just like customers in a grocery store, they're going to, some want curbside pickup. Others are going to want to do self-checkout. Some are going to use a company to order the groceries online and have it delivered to them. But it's really important to have a variety of different delivery mechanisms because at the end of the day, you're working with a variety of different end consumers. So to wrap it up, based on everything discussed, adopting a data product approach helps organizations break down data silos, enables their end users to have access to high quality data that they can understand. Ultimately, this unlocks the full potential of an organization's data, enables them to make more informed decisions with better business outcomes. Thanks for watching.